in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes. And something without warning, love, bears heavy on my mind.
Wake up, open my eyes, beautiful girl lying by my side. Right eye, I was trying to find someone we tried to hide the previous night. Surprise, surprise, open the blinds and try to get some light. Look outside and everything is right. What a wonderful week to be getting a flight. You hop on the train, we say goodbye. I go to work, but I haven't got the time to finish my notes. I need to leave at 5 on the roads to be close, cause there's no hope when I get the girls where they need to be. A little late, but they're pleased to see. But sunny meadows kept retreat. Kissed them both on the cheek, but now I need to leave. I haven't packed, but I need to go. Grab an overnight bag full of clothes. Back to work to finish my notes. Check into the travel log just before close. Wake up at 5 with 3 hours sleep. Look back outside, there's no change to sleep. The train's on time, but finally I get on the line. But it's going slowly. Oh, please God, don't you know? I got a plane to catch, don't go slow. The conductor comes up like, yo. We're stopping a dick up because we're slow. I'm like, shit, what did he just say, dick up? I shit you not, his cane was a big shot. I check my wrist watching, guess what? I've already missed my connection to the next stop. I call my mum, like, what shall I do? Cause I'm running out of options, haven't got a clue. She's being kind, but she knows I'm screwed. Like, can you get another flight if I pay for you? I'm like, yeah, I can get late the flight today. There's one space left and it'll cost 2k. With a bigger problem, I should probably say. And my fiance is on the same plane. Before I can pay, we pull up at the station. 2 hours late, and then my heart is racing. I'm facing the fact I might not make it, but that's not an option. I got a plane to get. I start thinking to myself, I need a backup plan. I'm gonna have to suck it up and get a taxi, man. But that's fine, it's a train station, there has to be plenty. It's the one time I've seen a taxi rank empty. I'm calling up, like, when's the next one coming? They're all on call, cause the trains aren't running. No shit, that's my predicament. I've had enough. Right now, my flight is 2 hours away. I've got an hour journey and a half hour wait. Safe to say, I can afford no more delays. I need a 4-door estate now before I break down. The taxi turns up, yeah, I finally got one. By now, I've got 2 girls riding shotgun. One's posting everything on their Insta story. And even the taxi driver's looking for me. It's going slow on the B-roads because of the snow. We hit the motorway and watch that motherfucker go. I'm starting to think, like, how did you make it? Kinda tighter than lighter, but fuck it, I'll take it. But then I'm like, kind sir, why is the windscreen full of white stuff? It's freezing up because the drivers forgot to put water in the jet to his wipe. There's no time to pull over, so cue the next scene. Hanging out the window, pouring water in his windscreen. The girls in the backseat think I've lost it, but I'm getting that plane at any cost. Shit, we made it. Close shaved it, 120 quid. Yeah, I paid it, 20 quid tip, cause the day he saved it. Gotta be polite to say goodbye to the ladies. But then I'm like, I gotta go, yo, fuck it. Presume security, cause I got my whole luggage. Get to the gate, I'm like, yo, don't shut it. You're passing so fast, my whole heart's in my stomach. Get to my seat, finally I can relax. Drink, sir, yes, please, I'll have 3 double checks. We land late that night, but I still can't proceed. Cause proposal isn't until tomorrow evening. But it's been a long journey, so I know I need to eat. But I need to go somewhere, I know there wouldn't be. Looking over my shoulder, every time I hear a peep. I grab some tap ass and then I go to sleep. I wake up, open my eyes. Phone is ringing by my side. Bree is calling and I'm like, why? I'm supposed to be in work and I don't wanna lie. I deal with that, but then my mom texts too. And now he's asking for a picture of you. I asked a friend to send a picture from the roof. It's the wrong apartment, the fucking little dude. I minimize the lies I need to memorize. My wife is about to stay out of sight until tonight. This might be the greatest thing I've ever done in my life. I asked Bree what she's got planned that day. Sean's going to the gym, but Bree's gonna stay in the room. I'm like, that's a good plan, babe. After such a long journey, you deserve a break. Now this wasn't always in my plan, but here's my chance to get an inside man. Let me join the gym, I tell them what I'm gonna do. I'll meet them later on to get the key to the room. Rest of the day I'm trying to lie low on a lie low. Pina colada sipping down my throat. 10 in the morning, but now hard I go. All inclusive, so I half I moan. But now I actually need a strategy. I can't casually walk up and ask this girl to marry me. After all the planning, what a tragedy. One anticlimax, that'll be. So about me. Then I speak to the maitre d'. I'm like, yo, baby, you gotta help me, please. Need your post, but Lord knows the creativity is not my strong suit. So maybe we come to the plan together. Something is better than leather. Something you never forget, no matter whatever they give us. We brainstorm and come up with a plan to propose. Yours and rose petals and a single rose. I go back to pick them up later on. I say thank you. We go to the bar to meet Sean. We toast the drink, then we toast another one. Grab the key card, now I gotta get gone. Back in the room, I'm waiting for Sean's text. The reach room's on the other side of the complex. Then it lands, 15 minutes, showtime. Grab the ring of roses, I'll be over there in no time. Walking across the complex, feeling like Cupid. Looking for the Cinderella that my shoe fits. Wait, did I say Cupid? I meant stupid. I just realized I don't know where the room is. I run back to the front desk. I'm a dumb mess. I'm like, miss, I don't know if you remember me, but I'm begging on my knees, can you help me please? She tells me where to go when I get back on my bike. Somehow I still make it there just in time. Sean takes three into the parents' room. So now it's time for me to prepare to make my move. I've been through every step in my head, I've just got one more. Put the key card in, but it's the wrong door. The room attendant sees me looking all nervous, so he helps me out, knock, room service. No response, I'm hoping, but then the goddamn door opens. I'm fucked now, I gotta think fast, I duck down. Behind the drink car, the door shuts now. I gotta sprint fast at the corporate door. Wow, I made it that last. Open the door, throw the roses on the floor. Get on the balcony and get down on me. Put on Eminem song, finally I can breathe. And now I wait for Sean to send free into me. A couple of minutes later, I hear the door open. 5 seconds later, I hear the door closing. We got spooked, went back to the other room. By this point, they all know I'm about to do. Send her back to me, and this time she doesn't leave. Opens the door to the balcony to see me on one knee, asking if we could be my wife. And the rest is history.